rotation, if cell 1 to material intake, then it will do endocytosis process. If it will active, so it will use exocytosis process. So you can say the exocytosis process is reverse process of endocytosis process, and reverse process of moving material into a cell is the process of exocytosis, and exocytosis process is opposite of the process discussed in the our last session of endocytosis process, and this material is enveloped in a membrane, or you can say it will be fused in a vacuole and within the cell, and fuses with the interior of the plasma membrane. This fusion opens the membrane envelope on the exterior of the cell, and waste material is expelled into the extracellular space. Other examples of cells releasing molecules via exocytosis includes the secretion of proteins of extracellular matrix and secretion of neurotransmitters into the synaptic cleft by synaptic vesicles. Exocytosis process occurring in plant and animal cell both that involves moving material within a cell to the exterior of the cell. This process requires energy and it is a type of active transport, but it is bulk transport. Exocytosis is the opposite of the endocytosis, as I have told in our previous slide. So in which substance are taken into the cell and in the endocytosis process, but in the exocytosis process it is taken out. In exocytosis, membrane bound vesicles, or you can say vacuoles containing cellular molecules, are transported to the cell membrane. Let's look at some examples of cellular secretory products which are secreted out with the help of exocytosis process. First is secreted proteins like enzymes, peptide hormones and antibodies, neurotransmitters from nerve cells, plasma membrane proteins. Antigens means pieces of bacteria and other inhibitors which stimulate the immune response. There are five steps which are involved in the exocytosis process. First is the vesicle trafficking. In this first step, the vesicle containing the waste product and chemical transmitter is transported through the cytoplasm towards the part of the cell from which it will be eliminated. Second is vesicle tethering. As the vesicle approaches the cell membrane, it is secured and pulled towards the part of the cell from which it will be eliminated. Third one is vesicle docking. In this step, the vesicle comes in contact with the cell membrane, and where it begins to chemical and physically merge with the proteins in the cell membrane. Fourth one is vesicle priming. In those cells where chemical transmitters are being released, this step involves the chemical preparation for the last step of the exocytosis. Last step is vesicle fusion. In this step, the proteins forming the walls of the vesicle merge with the cell membrane and wretch, pushing the vesicle contents, which is waste products or chemical transmitters, out of the cell. This step is the primary mechanism for increasing the size of the cell plasma membrane. Here we can see the diagram in which this is a vesicle having waste material or transmitters. They will move within the cytoplasm, and further they will go to the part of cell membrane where it has to fuse, and this vesicle finally will fuse to this plasma membrane and then release the waste material or transmitter out of the cell. So this is the sum up of this session, and this session is powered by Digital Version 2.0, Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University. Hope you are satisfied with this session. If you have any query, then mention in the comment box. I will resolve it. Thank you.